Good morning, children. Welcome back. How are you all? Hope you are staying at home and taking care of yourself and your parents, brothers and sisters. Are you following our lessons or not? Yes. Pay some interest. Listen to our lessons carefully. Okay? Are you ready to listen today for today's lesson? Oh, very good. Yesterday, we started the lesson, Oliver asks for more. Oliver asks for more. Do you know who is the author of this lesson? Who is the writer of this lesson? Anyone remember? Anyone? Yes, you are right. The author's name is Charles Dickens. Charles Dickens, a British writer, famous writer, novelist. He has written many novels. Our present lesson, Oliver Asks for More, is an extract from this novel, Oliver Twist. Name of the novel is Oliver Twist. Yesterday we started this lesson. The main character in this lesson is Oliver. Do you remember who was Oliver? Yesterday I told you. Do you remember who was Oliver? Yes, you are right. Oliver was an orphan boy. Orphan boy who was brought up by the parish. Parish meaning a church committee. Oliver was brought up by a parish or a church committee. And from there, Oliver was sent to workhouse. Workhouse is also called, known as orphanage. Do you know the meaning of orphanage? As I told you, anyone can tell me what's the meaning of orphanage? Yes, you are right. Orphanage is a place where orphan children are taken care of. They live there and they are given food, shelter, even education. Okay? You are right. So yesterday I told you, if you find any child laborers, any children below the age of 14 working at different places, in shops or in construction sites or in the fields or in the hotels, if you find children working, children who are below 14 years, you can inform child helpline number 1098, and the child will get help. He will be taken from that workplace where he is working and he will be admitted in an orphanage where he will be given free food, accommodation and even education. You know, as children, all of you have your rights, child rights. One of the important rights of every child is right to education. Right to education. You should get your education, basic education. And you also should get love and affection from your parents. Love and affection from your parents. But Oliver was an unfortunate child who lost his parents at a small age, young age. Then he was taken into the care of the parish. He was looked after by the parish and the parish sent him to workhouse where many children were living. He was taken there. He was a small boy. He did not know what is workhouse. He was taken there. He was taken there by Mr. Bumble, warden of the workhouse, Mr. Bumble. Okay? So there he faced the board where 8 to 10 fat gentlemen were sitting on the chairs. In front of them there was a long table and on the chairs 8 to 10 people, it's called board of directors, were sitting. Oliver was brought there and asked to bow his head to the board. He was almost crying. He bowed his head to the table there. Then A man sitting in the high chair asked Oliver one question. Do you remember that question? Are you an orphan? Oliver did not know the meaning of orphan, so he did not say anything. Okay, then, yes sir, replied Oliver, weeping bitterly. Orphan meaning said, don't have your father, you don't have your mother, that is why you are called an orphan. Oliver started weeping bitterly. Till there, yesterday, we studied. Now, once again, I am requesting everyone to open your books and follow the lesson. Look at your books carefully, or read and I will explain. You can ask any doubts if you get in my next class. Okay. Are you ready now for today's class? Right. What are you crying for? Inquired the gentleman in the white waistcoat. A boy. Oliver, why are you crying? I hope you say your prayers every night, said another gentleman in a gruff voice. There were 8 to 10 people sitting. Another gentleman said to Oliver, I hope you say your prayers every night before sleeping. He said in a gruff voice. What is the meaning of gruff voice? Rough voice or harsh voice, not a soft voice. And pray for the people who feed you and take care of you. Like a Christian, like a good Christian, you should pray for the people who are feeding you, meaning providing you food and taking care of you. So for all these people, every night you should pray, said another gentleman. Yes sir, stammered the boy. Oliver said, yes sir, I pray for the people who take care of me. Well, you have come here to be educated and taught a useful trade, said the red-faced gentleman in the high chair. Red-faced gentleman sitting on the high chair, he said, you are brought here to be educated and also you will be taught a useful trade. What is the meaning of trade? Trade meaning doing some work or doing some business. Because after the education, they should go out, they should work and earn their living. That is why in the workhouse, children or orphans, they will be provided food, they will be provided education, and at the same time, they will be taught a trade. Able to do some work. So you will begin to pick oakum tomorrow morning at 6 o'clock, added the surly one in the white waistcoat. So another man in the white waistcoat said to Oliver, tomorrow morning onwards you will start picking up oakum. Do you know the meaning of oakum? O-A-K-U-M. O-A-K-U-M. What is the meaning of oakum? Anyone? What is the meaning of oakum? Oakum, for example, you know the ropes. These days we find ropes which are made up of plastic fibers. But in olden days there were ropes which are made up of fiber that is obtained from, for example, coconut fiber or jute fiber. With that fiber we prepare ropes. For example, farmers use ropes in their work in the field, or drawing muller carts, or tying the luggage on the cart and so on. They have big ropes. These ropes are made up of using fibers, not only jute fibers, we also take fibers from coconut fiber. With that we make ropes. Your picking up oakum is, these orphan children in the orphanage, they will be given old ropes, broken ropes, damaged ropes. And what they should do, they should remove all the fibers from the ropes. So the using these fibers, they can prepare new ropes once again, just like recycling. So children will be trained in that to pick up kokum. Have you understood what is kokum? It's a fiber with which ropes are made. They have to untwist the ropes and remove the fiber from the ropes. Add the surly one in the white waistcoat. Surly meaning bad tempered gentleman said, tomorrow morning onwards you have to start picking up kokum. Oliver bowed low, directed by the beadle, and was then hurried away to a large ward where on a rough hard bed he sobbed himself to sleep. So after speaking to that boy, the beadle took him to another room, hurried away to a large ward where on a rough hard bed, not soft bed, a table like bed, he was asked to lie down and sleep. It was a new place for him and he was sobbing bitterly, crying bitterly, and after a long time he slept off. Small boy was so much afraid being in a new place first day. Poor Oliver, as he lay sleeping unconscious of everything around him, the board had taken a decision that would change the course of his life. While Oliver was sleeping, the board members had taken a decision about what to do with the orphans who are living in that workhouse or orphanage. So their decision changed the life of Oliver, or Oliver Twist. Okay. So what happened to Oliver Twist is a long story narrated by Charles Dickens. But we have a small portion of this story. The members of this board were very wise and philosophical men. They were very wise and philosophical. Comes from the word philosophy. Philosophy meaning love of wisdom. Love of wisdom. Or the synonym is wise. They were very wise men, clever men. Who? Members of the board. As they turned their attention to the workhouse, they discovered that it was a regular place of public entertainment for the poorer classes. So they started, the board members started, what to discussing what is happening in the workhouse. And they understood that the workhouse has become a place of entertainment for poor children. They understood that the workhouse became a place of entertainment for poor children, where there is all, see here, public entertainment for the poorer classes, regular place of public entertainment for the poorer classes. It was a place where they had breakfast, dinner, tea and supper all the year round and free. They understood that it was a place where the orphans get their breakfast, lunch, tea, dinner or supper, everything, all 365 days of the year, free of cost. Free of cost. Understood? So that's what they understood. It was a place where it was all play and no work. Children play, children eat, but they were not given any work. So they decided to do something. They don't want large number of orphans live freely in that workhouse. They decided to do something. This was really shocking state of affairs. Very shocking news. Why children should be given everything free, food and education, and why they should not be given any work there? They should be given work. This was very shocking state of affairs, where they were of the opinion that the poor should be given only two alternate I have to start quickly outside the workhouse or gradually inside the house. So the members of the board had taken a decision. The children were given two alternatives. What are those two? Either to starve them inside the workhouse or outside the workhouse. What is the meaning of starve? S-T-A-R-V-E. What is the meaning of starve? Starve meaning to provide no food. Make them to live with hunger so that gradually they become very weak, sick, and they go out of this workhouse. So that is why the members of the board decided either to starve them quickly outside the workhouse. If they were sent out of the workhouse, they will be starved there outside very quickly because no one will give them food. Or if they are inside, they want to reduce the quantity of the food supplied to them so that slowly, slowly they will be starving and they will leave the place. Or gradually inside the workhouse. With this view, they decided that the inmates of the workhouse would be issued 3 meals of thin gruel a day with an onion twice a week. So the board members decided to reduce the quantity and quality of the food that was supplied to orphans. So what type of food they wanted to give them? They decided that the inmates of the workhouse, means who are living in the workhouse, they would be issued 3 meals of thin gruel, G-R-U-E-L, gruel. We know what's the meaning of gruel. Gruel meaning is a soft liquid food generally made out of oats. We say java or bison. Okay? Like that. Gruel is a thin liquid food made out of oats. So that type of gruel they want to give them. How many times? 3 meals of gruel a day with an onion twice a week. They will also supply them onion only 2 times a week. So their food will be very less in quantity and less in quality also. So that they will be starving, they will live with hunger and they will automatically leave the place. The board members wanted to send children out of the workhouse. Okay children? So here we are ending the day 7 of our session. Please, whatever I have explained, once again you read the lesson and you underline the words which you did not understand, and you also learn the meanings of these words. Okay? Are you ready? Are you ready to learn all the meanings, learn the lesson carefully? Right? Okay, children.